What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to upload an advanced generation world on a 7 Days to Die server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Hosting a 7 Days to Die server introduces a ton of features, with one of them being the ability to upload worlds. This process allows owners to share their single-player maps with other players, or users can create advanced worlds to play with friends. Compared to normal worlds, advanced ones take more time to prepare due to the game's design. But once everything is completed, you'll be able to enjoy custom maps for an exciting zombie experience. Before uploading an advanced world to your 7 Days to Die server, you're going to need to make one. Start up 7 Days to Die on Steam and click New Game, and then you can enter anything you would like in the Game Name field and then make a note of it for later. Continue to change Game World to New Random World, and then you can set the World Generation Seed and World Size values to what you want. Copy the World Seed and Size values and then click the Advanced Generation button. Now you can paste them in their respective fields and customize the other settings to your liking. When everything is done, press Generate World at the bottom and wait for it to load. And then once this finishes, click back and find the Generated World Name field. Next, switch the Game World option to the one that you copied and enter the corresponding game name value. With these fields correctly set up, you can press Start to confirm the generation. Make sure to copy the generated world name, world generation seed, world size, and game name. These are going to be used for preparing the files and configuring your server, so you're going to need them in a minute. Press the Windows key and R on your keyboard, and then enter %appdata%\7daystodie\ in the text box. Click OK and open the saves directory and compress your generated world name folder into a zip file for your program. Next, return to the main 7 Days to Die area and open the generated worlds and compress the same generated world name folder. Afterwards, you should have two identical zip files in the generated worlds and the saves folders. You are going to have to use an external FTP program like FileZilla because of the file size. Once you have that external program downloaded, you can open it and log in with your account details. Head towards the correct server profile directory, which should reveal your 7 Days to Die server files. Now you can find and enter the saves folder and then drag the zipped generated world name file from the saves folder on your computer into this area. You're going to do the same thing for the generated worlds directory with its respective zip file. Wait for all of these to finish uploading, and then you can confirm their separate locations. Head towards your Apex server panel and click FTP file access near the top left, and then log in and enter the saves folder. While inside, checkmark the generated world name folder and press unzip at the top. You can submit the changes and then do the exact same thing for the generated worlds directory. After that, you can head to the server config XML file in the main server file and click edit to the right-hand side. On the next page, find the game world setting and change its value to your generated world name, which is the same name from the files that you zipped. Next, set the world gen seed and world gen size to their respective values that you copied from earlier. Once this is done, you can finally change the game name to your game name value, and then you can press save at the top and restart the server. If you get an inverse host lookup failed error, this is the most common problem, and it happens when the server is unable to load the advanced generated world. Double check the information and values in your server config XML file. These values should be the exact same ones that you used to create in-game. If this is all correct, then you can see if the zipped files were correctly uploaded. These will have the same zip file names, but each are different since they originated in the saves and generated world directories. Make sure they're in the right server profile and location in the FTP panel to load the world. Another popular issue is missing the generated worlds directory in your server files. If this happens, then log into the FTP file access area and press New Folder in the top left corner. Create one called .local and then continue making more that follows the local, share, 7 days to die, and generated worlds directory, putting each new folder within the last. Uploading worlds can get confusing, but it's something that really pays off in the end. Soon enough, you'll be able to share your new world with friends and go to war with the zombies at hand. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.